of the day here in deepest, darkest Cornwall, deepest, sunniest Cornwall, should we say. And Lucy and me, we're off to Land's End. We are travelling as far west as we can go from our little hideout in Cornwall until we hit the coast. So it's a couple of hours drive and we're going to pass through Penzance and we're going to go as close as we can get to the Land's End. I think it's one of the closest campsites to Land's End and we're off to stay there in our little classic. And last time when we went to the festival, I talked about immigration, and today I'm going to talk about one of my most favourite topics.
So the only way to hit military targets, missile launchers or airfields which are conducting attacks against Ukraine, is to hit military targets on Russian territory, because the front line and the border line is more or less the same. And therefore I welcome that allies have loosened their restrictions, and there's no doubt that Ukraine has the right to use...
That's war, because right now all the top brass, the Jens Stoltenbergs, Keir Starmer, yeah, who, rumour has it, was elected just in time for this NATO summit that's happening this weekend. Joe Biden's there, he's livening everything up. In fact, I think he said to Jens Stoltenberg that he was fucking his wife. I'm not sure if that was just a slip or if he actually said that. But anyway, well done Sleepy Joe for livening up the NATO summit. And obviously they're all there to get their instructions. As I just said, Sunak, Rishi Sunak, now a leader of the opposition, he called the general election on the July the 4th, American Independence Day, just in time for this NATO summit, so Starmer could go there and receive his instructions. We were just talking about, you were talking about some guy from Scrapyard that Lucy was talking to the other day. They end up talking about war. Everyone's off grid where I'm staying at the moment. And he was saying, oh, I think a war will come in August. I think that's exactly what's going to happen. I think the new MPs are going to be bedding into Parliament over the next couple of weeks, and they go on their holiday and summer recess. Parliament shuts down. The villagers got elected, they're going on holiday. Fucking good life, isn't it? And then over the summer holidays, and almost certainly between now and the end of October, there's going to be an incident, a false flag, an attack, something's going to happen, and they're all going to be recalled to Parliament, and all these new wet behind the ear and ear MPs are going to have no bloody idea what to do. And so they're going to look to the senior MPs, you know, or maybe we're going to look to the foreign secretary. What are you doing in a war situation? I don't know. We'll look to the foreign secretary. Who's the foreign secretary? David Lammy. Doesn't know what cervix is. So I think that's what's going to happen. I think by the end of the summer, it may well have all kicked off. So do what they're doing in Cornwall. Hide your kids away. We're near Penzance, right? 20 miles out of Penzance. I don't know if you can pick it up on the camera, but we are absolutely surrounded by wind farms. It's dystopian, to say the least, to see the big blades just appear on the horizon ahead of you on this motorway that we're taking down to the far, far southwest, Land's End. Lucy and I have arrived at Sea View Holiday Park, I think that's its proper name, and we've got the old classic set up with our new awning. Hey, it's got windows, which is great, and it's really good. We didn't have a proper look at this last time we went to the festival. I didn't show this on camera, but it's actually really good. I can stand up. There's loads of room. We've got like mod cons. Lucy's happy because we've got a little garden today.
Yeah,
nice. And check out what it's like to be at the most westward point in the UK. And to my shame, I have never been this far west. I think.
at Land's End. And literally before we get to the sea, there's this little, these little recreations of buildings from around Cornwall. Where's the Tintagel post office? Down there. Looks like an interesting, nice little models. What's this one? Rose Cottage Tavern. I don't know where that is. I'm trying to think of. You're not climbing on the models, Lucy. You've also got people climbing on them. But anyway, so we've got these nice models, and there's a nice plaque explaining them all. And then we've got this. Right in the middle is this little stone circle, and there's nothing explaining what the stone circle is, which is interesting, isn't it? It's all about the models, not that stone circle there. You can see in the distance there's the Land's End Lighthouse, which was built and completed in 1875. Makes you wonder how they did it, because it's a mile and a half offshore. So anyway, I've never been here. There's a little shopping village. Super expensive, of course. It's Cornwall, has to be super expensive in the poorest place in the whole of the UK. So behind me, you can just see it there, is Longship's Lighthouse. That's its name. You see that? Mm-hmm. Oh, the world farm up there is the world's most famous signpost that everybody wants to get a picture of.
Yes,
so I can't really carry out for that shit. Yeah. But it just tells you how far it is to New York, in that direction.
And
I've pointed at a lot of things in my videos, and I've never pointed towards New York. And for those who care, me and Lucy have been wandering around, joined at the hip for 14 weeks. That's how long it's been.
Yeah.
And now we're living together. Yeah. See how that works. And nobody knows where I am, which is great.
Yeah.
Or where Lucy is, for that matter. But I'm more off-grid now than you are.
Yes, you are,
actually. That's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
I like it. Lucky. Does it seem like longer than 14 weeks, Anna, Lucy?
Mainly because we're together every day. So, it seems like an eternity. No, I'm joking.
It does.
I'm only joking.
She disappeared a minute ago and I blew a sigh of relief.
I ran away.
There you go. We agree on everything that's fucking important. Like, Keir Starmer's a cunt. We're about to have a war. Yeah. No one should be getting vaccinated. We're ruled over by criminal psychopaths, you're calling a satanic cabal.
Yeah.
And UFOs, aliens is important that we agree on. We disagree on directions and things like that.
Yeah.
Anyway, most of this will get cut for the video. I just posted a nice picture on Twitter. And as a Twitter addict that I am, I thought I would have a look to see what's going on. And lo and behold, I see breaking news just been announced. Keir Starmer has given permission to Ukraine to use UK weapons and fire them into mainland Russia and attack targets, strategic or civilian, who knows, in Russia. That's Keir Starmer, Labour Party leader, party of love and war, apparently. So I just thought I'd add to this video that seems war was my plan, sort of subtext in terms of politics, while I'm here at Land's End with Lucy. And you are now a target. If you live in a major city, if you live near a military base, if you live anywhere that stores ammo, that supplies weapons and missiles, that builds them, you are potentially now a target, because Putin, eventually, he's going to say, well, wait a sec, UK weapons attacking our cities and towns. There's probably British troops on the soil, NATO troops. There's a summit now. I'm sure they're planning how they can escalate things further. You are now a target, because sooner or later, you know, this is going to spill out of the boundaries of Ukraine. Yeah, it's Russia versus the rest of the West. And what could possibly fucking go wrong? Anyway. I thought I'd add that. That was Lucy's idea. She said you should put that on camera. So I did.
Yeah. What happened just now?
Yeah. What do you think, Lucy? What do you think about UK weapons being used?
Well, I think we've just made ourselves a target, really. And there's nothing we can do about it.
Yeah. Go off grid. Get out of the way. Hide your sons and daughters. Cat, come down to Land's End, the most westerly point in the whole of the UK, without coming to get a good picture of the sunset, which can't really see at the moment. Put it in, I'll cut it into the video. But right now, the view that we can see over there towards the ocean, out across the Atlantic, we could sort of see the Scilly Isles, which we've considered going to, didn't we? We've talked about going to the Scilly tomorrow, yeah. Maybe. See how much it costs. But this view here is absolutely spectacular. And we're in some farmer's field. So this is a wheat field, I think. Wheat, is it? Or barley or corn? It's not probably grown yet.
Wheat,
yeah. And gotta say that down here, Land's End, probably the most remote place that me and you have travelled in the last 2-3 months.
And the cottages are from
1600s. Yeah, I mean, some of the buildings here are really, really old. You can see there's the where we went down earlier. That's where we went earlier. And there's a few buildings over there. And there's a little village called Senon, and another one called Mayon, which goes on just a bit further. Senon, it's got a pub there called The First and Last, which was established in 1620, right next to a church, which is probably the same age, isn't it?
Maybe older.
Yeah. So the smugglers used to come in here, and the first place they would go is to the church. Probably to...
And the pub.
Yeah, to wash the sins out, and then the pub wash everything else out. So, happy days. The good old days. For a midnight stroll, so to speak. It's about 10:30. There's an old dairy, and we're just walking back to our campsite. And this place, man, Land's End, is a bit weird because there is nothing here. Yeah, there's absolutely nothing here. They do have a wind turbine though, or a couple. So we're in Penzance. Lucy, how do you say Penzance welcomes you? Oh, I can't see it now. Oh yeah, I can.
Insanzagursonigurg.
She just made that up. It's written on the wall over there. Penzance agag dinerg. That's how you say it in Cornish. Yeah, like a true pro. She just makes stuff up. Penzance town centre. It's got very much a seaside feel to it. We're going to be travelling around to the other side of the bay to see if we get across to St. Michael's Mount, which lays on a ley line. And Lucy wants to go and do some over at St. Michael's Mount, which is really interesting because that ley line, all the towns along that ley line, right across Europe, have a St. Michael's smell or taint to the name. Anyway, this is Penzance. No. They need to be. Actually a lot bigger than I give it credit for. It's a hidden little gem, isn't it, in behind that seafront where there's not a lot going on. Yeah. And then you go down a back street in Penzance and the flavour changes rapidly. So there was a whole bunch of people drunk on the streets, just lying about, homeless. So, yeah, and me and Lucy had this conversation. Places like Penzance or Plymouth or Torquay or anywhere on the coast, particularly in the southwest where it's warmer, we get a lot of homelessness and drug addiction and mental health problems because people come down here. Yeah, they arrive here and they're like, oh, this is quite nice. I can get, instead of getting pissed in the middle of Manchester, I'm going to get pissed by the seaside and Penzance.
Yeah.
That's what they do. And who would blame them? I don't blame them. Lucy's new hairband. Oh, I don't know. Hippies. This is what a car without power steering looks like, trying to get out of a tight parking space.
Yeah.
And I have to say that I'm a non-driver. Lucy has remarkable driving skills considering she's driving a fucking tank.
And I've got some muscles.
And she's got some muscles.
Just from steering.
Yeah. There we go, well done. That was a tight spot. So we are at a place called Marazion. And actually, we've just been debating the origins of the word Zion. You think it's
African?
She thinks it's African.
Bob Marley.
Because of Bob Marley, yeah. So we'll have to look that up. Over there is the Mount of St. Michael. You can walk across to it in low tide. Low tide's not for a few hours though, so we might not hang around that long, but we might be able to get a boat across. So
get a boat across and then walk back along the causeway.
There we go, that's what we're going to do.
Like the lion in Zion.
I'm gonna be iron like the lion in Zion. I'm gonna be iron like the lion in Zion.
So we're hopeful that we can walk across now. National Trust strikes again.
Yeah.
30 quid that cost. We walked across the water and they go, you got your ticket? You go, what? And they go, well, we just want to go on the island. We go, 30 quid, mate.
Yeah.
So, and that's just, yeah. And that's just to go to the castle. To go to the gardens, it would have cost us only 60 quid. Fuck it, now, man. That's what I come here for. I come here for the silver. The Archangel.
Archangel Michael. He's even got wings.
Angel Michael, slaying the devil or the demon. And that's what all these buildings that go along this ley line, right through Europe, it's all to do with the Angel Michael, Archangel Angel Michael. And he was a warrior for God, was he not?
I think so.
Yes.
Fighting against Satanic.
Lucy loves it.
Yeah.
a good question to ask on Twitter. Should all women be able to suck? Yeah, it's all very interesting, Lucy, isn't it? It's very rich and wealthy. There are people still living here. This whole island is dedicated to the upkeep of the grounds and the castle and all the people here. Now, for when we do return, we're at the top of the castle.
It's gone, the tide's gone out. You know, the tide's gone out. There was not much water yesterday.
This is Marazion. It's very, 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 very little here. And if it wasn't for the castle, the monastery over at St. Michael's Mount, which must be making a tremendous amount of money, you know, this economy here, this village would be dead. You know, it would just be for rich people to come and live there.
Oh. It's the wrong side of the road.
Yeah.
That would have been filmed.
I love the times I hold my breath. Just driving around here. Lucy thought St. Just was going to be exciting. Yeah. Like she remembered it. And we've walked for about 20, 30 seconds and we've seen it all. Biggest thing I've noticed here is here in St. Just, Penzance, Marazion, whatever it was called. Marazion. Is that the moving population, the people milling around in the streets and the shops and the pubs and everything, none of them speak English. They're all visitors, they're all tourists and that. There's so many different languages and accents that you hear, particularly down Land's End yesterday. I mean, they're all Indian. In fact, where we're camping now is a load of Indian people, which is, they're great, but it's just weird, you know what I mean? When you're in such a place like this, is St. Just at the back end, really at the back end of back arse of England, down at Land's End, one of the most remote places I've ever been to.
Yeah.
And it's all foreigners, it's all visitors, it's all tourists. Weird, right? In fact, there was even a Russian standing out, giant Russian standing outside the pub, half cut, shouting in Russian, having a cigarette. That was in Seven. Seven, population 12, you know what I mean? One of them's Russian. This is Sanen Cove. We're actually not staying too far from here. And me and Lucy have probably done about 20 odd miles on foot in the last 2 days.
Okay.
Just walking. We've been in the van as well. In fact, golf for the van. And although Lucy wants to go to an art gallery. Minor protesting from Darren, and then we're going back. So Lucy can't tell the difference between a ribeye and a rump steak.
No, both.
So that's the rump steak.
This is the rump.
Yeah, it's going to be tough as hell. Like all fucking boots.
Okay.
Is it cooked?
Yes.
It's well done. Ugh. We've also got some, what's that one? Sweet Papa Ray. Sweet Baby Ray's honey barbecue sauce. Excellent. Right, so that's the ribeye, which is the high quality cut meat, or considered so.
Yeah, okay.
And that ribeye's actually not looking too bad considering what we've had to cook with.
Well, I want to try it first without any sauce.
Oh, okay.
So I can get the flavour.
Okay.
Okay. So this is the ribeye. It's a lot softer.
Mm. And it's not even cooked very well because we're using a fucking camping
stove. Yeah, that's a lot softer. Not as much chewing involved.
No. It's not a hard work to swallow.
Mm. Okay, but.
Mm. Say that again.
I've never seen steak on a menu with eggs.
Okay.
It's usually steak and chips.
With egg.
No, I've never seen an egg on a menu with steak.
Had the worst night's sleep camping since me and Lucy have started camping together last night.
The awning is slightly too big. We haven't quite worked out how to fit it to the van properly. So it was really, really windy last night. So the noise was a freaking nightmare. So neither of us sat very well. And we're on our way back now to the secret Cornish hideout. There's been no nuclear weapons fired at this part of the world yet. So that's good. And, that was a Kestrel. And we had a good time down. We had a good time, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. We had a couple of good days. It was just last night. I had about 1.5 hours sleep.
So anyway, next time I'll record a video, hopefully, fingers crossed, we will be headed towards Wales. Because I'm still planning to do and complete my mission. I probably won't be doing it quite as in full as I had intended, because I've still got a really sore back and I won't be hiking it all. I just can't do it. But we can do it in the van. The van is probably going to be named Ruby by then. Yeah.
Yeah, like Ruby.
There you go. We've got a name for the van. It's called Ruby because it's red, and because somebody, Evorgy, on Twitter, he said call it Ruby. So Lucy likes Evorgy. So we're going to do that. Anyway, that's our little latest mission over. I hope you enjoyed the video. Do give us a like and a share and a comment next time. Hopefully, we'll be headed towards Wales to see if we can conquer Snowdon. Over out. Say goodbye, Lucy.
Bye.
And I'm also pleased to announce that as we speak, the transfer of F-16 jets is underway. Coming from Denmark, coming from the Netherlands. And those jets will be flying in the skies of Ukraine this summer to make sure that Ukraine can continue to effectively defend itself against the Russian aggression.